Next, the poster number 35, a study of outpatient department surgical unit service at the Lady Ridgeview Hospital for Children, Colombo. The presenting author is Ranavaka UARS.
Good afternoon, chairpersons, judges, and ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, I would like to congratulate the president and the council and all the organizers for organizing this international congress amid the COVID crisis. So coming back to the presentation, it's about the study of outpatient department surgical unit services at the Lady Ridgeview Hospital for Children, Colombo. OPD surgical unit of the LRH is the only such unit in Sri Lanka catering day surgical services to the children of this country. So one aim of presentation here is to advocate day surgeries so that the time of hospital's stay is less, and also to share our experience with others how we manage the unit with limited resources. So the OPD surgical unit of the hospital composed of clinic functioning from 8 to 12, that is 4 hours, from Monday to Thursday, and theater that from on Fridays and Saturdays, that is 4 hours as well. So the patients were operated at the day surgical, at the theater on Fridays and Saturdays, were followed up at the day surgical unit. So the unit composed of one consultant and 3 regular medical officers. And so we audited the number of new clinic attendees, surgeries done under GA, and clinic procedures. We audited this intending to improve the service quality. We had monthly discussions with all our team members. So the study period was 4 years, the time duration I was there, from the 1st of January 2014 to 31st of December 2017. The data was collected from the clinic registers and author's operations logbook. I have deliberately used tables to emphasize on the numbers. So firstly, on analyzing the new clinic attendees, the MOPDs are free to refer any number of patients to the day surgical unit, that is excluding the surgical emergencies, any numbers were welcome. So over these 4 years, we managed to see a monthly mean of around 400 over the 4 years, and there were above 16 monthly mean clinic sessions, and we managed to see more than 25 clinic attendees per each, new clinic attendees per each session. Coming to the analysis of number of surgeries done under GA in the day surgical unit, there were, the bed capacity was 7, and the theater time per session was 4 hours. Within this, utilizing these resources, over these 4 years, we managed to do around 60 surgeries, mean of 60 surgeries per month, and the mean theater sessions were around 8. And around above 7, mean around 7 numbers of mean surgeries were done. In 2017, there was a drop because by the mid-2016, there was establishment of another surgical unit. So the numbers we got was a bit less. Okay, then going to the analysis of clinic procedures, these included wound management, wound toilets, suture removers, and etc. And training patients and parents on bowel and bladder management, especially with children with overactive bladders. And there were others such as labial adhesion clearance and lumps removal, etc. So unfortunately, we started recording our procedures from 2015. So we managed to do around about 50 mean procedures every month. So, and coming back to the per day's work, we managed to do about 3 clinic procedures per per clinic session. Mind you, this is within these 4-hour clinic session while attending to the new clinic attendees plus the follow-up clinic attendees. So in conclusion, I would like to share that during the study period, we managed to have new clinic attendees per session around 25 and mean surgeries per theater session around 8 and mean number of clinic procedures about 3. So during the study period, the unit facilities and the staff remain same, but the anesthesia time changed because each time we anesthetize patient, the doctors changed. So that was one factor which limited the number of surgeries we were able to do each time. And we managed to do a bed occupancy in the surgery unit above 1, difficult task, with 4 hours of theater sessions. So I would like to emphasize that even with the limited facilities, you can achieve, you can do a reasonable service to the community. And so I would like everybody to elaborate on and then to practice the idea of day surgeries and plan how you do each procedures with limited facilities, such as limited theater time, as well as limited bed space. Thank you, and I would like to answer any questions.
Thank you. The session is open for discussion.
If the audience want to ask questions, you are welcome to do so. Only thing is you might have to shout because you are not sharing any microphones.
Okay, in the absence of questions from the audience, why do you think that the number of surgeries done, the mean number, gradually declines over time?
Actually, it's the last year that now the first year it was 67.5, 68.9, 67.1, and then 52.7 point. That was because another surgical unit was established in the end of 2016. So the patient distribution was, some of them went there as well.
But this is based on mean surgeries per theater session, is
yes,
it right?
Yes,
so that numbers probably might have increased. So it has remained the same because of the number of theaters. Okay.
Right, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.
Let's give a round of applause to the presenter.